Hi everyone, Aaron here for zollotech, and today Apple released watchOS 7.4 Beta 3. This is available to developers and hopefully soon to public beta testers. If you're not seeing it now, hopefully later today or tomorrow. Now let's go ahead and take a look at the size of it. And I took a screenshot of it earlier. You can see it was 200 megabytes. That's on my Series 6 Apple Watch, the titanium edition, but it shouldn't really make a difference as far as that goes. Let me go ahead and lock my iPhone and then unlock it so I can unlock the watch. And you'll see it says Aaron's Apple Watch unlocked. So the icon there is a little bit different. And along with this, Apple also released the other day iOS 14.5 Beta 3, iPadOS 14.5 Beta 3, tvOS 14.5 Beta 3, and macOS Big Sur 11.3 Beta 3. I covered those in different videos the other day. Now let's take a look at the build number and talk about what's new. So we'll go to our settings, then we'll go to general, then about, and you can see the build number is 18T5169F. And this particular build, while there's not really anything physical that you can see new in it, I am going to talk about what beta 1 and beta 2 had as well, because there were some changes along the way with that, but I didn't cover them in a previous video. But in beta 3 specifically, there's not anything physically new. There is some mentions in the code that if you swipe up here, go to cellular on a cellular version of the Apple Watch, you can disable cellular in the control center. However, we could do that before, so maybe some of the text has changed. So I don't see anything specifically new, and it seems to be the same. But with beta 1 and beta 2 was the introduction of face unlock wearing a mask using your Apple Watch with Face ID on the phone. There's also some icon changes that happened on the watch when you use that unlock that have changed. So let me show you that just in case you haven't seen that before. So we'll go into the Apple Watch, make sure it's unlocked here. That's part of that. I'll go ahead and turn on my camera on my iPhone so that you can see here. Let me put on the face mask here. And this is just a face mask for the example, and you can see I'm wearing it. You can hear the difference. Let me go ahead and lock my phone and we'll unlock it. And if you haven't activated this prior, maybe you put your watch on in the morning, it wasn't unlocked, and you can see now it says unlocking with this Apple Watch and it's locked. So it's giving me a little bit of an error. I need to put in my passcode first. Now let me do it one more time. And now that everything's been unlocked before, it unlocks. And you can see on the watch, it says unlocked by this Apple Watch, and then I can lock the phone. So that's new, as well as the icon that's here, that's been updated with beta 2. So that's working. I'll do it one more time, and it gives me haptic feedback on the wrist as well. So let me go ahead and remove the mask and talk about the other changes, because the only other major change with this has to do with Fitness or Fitness Plus on Apple. So if you're using Apple Watch with Fitness Plus, where it uses the metrics on the phone and the watch to sort of tell you what's going on with your movement on the screen. With the Fitness Plus subscription, you can use that with AirPlay 2 controls. However, you won't get the metrics with this. So maybe you're using a workout here and you're using it on the screen. Let's cancel that. It thinks I'm swimming here, but we'll move it over to here. And you'll see if you were using this, maybe Workout Plus or Fitness Plus and working out, it shows the metrics on the screen. But when you're airplaying, it doesn't. But that's all included in this particular update. And this update is said to be coming out in spring, according to Apple. And what that means is after March 20th, since after that, we get to spring. So with spring, it means late March or early April. And along with this release with watchOS 7.4, you can expect iOS 14.5 as well. So all of those should be coming in the spring, according to Apple. So that seems to make sense. Now, as far as the overall usability of the watch, so far today, installed after installing 7.4, it's been nice and fast. I haven't really had any slowdowns, any issues, whether that be with the control center, sliding between things, and performance seems to be what I would expect. As far as the battery life, well, it's been okay. After installing an update, it's always going to go down a little bit more quickly until it sort of finishes doing what it needs to do in the background. But generally, on beta 2, for example, I could get to the end of the day with around 70%. We're down a little bit, like I said, after installing this update, so it's going to be a little bit different. But in general, it seems to be performing well, and battery seems to be okay for me on this. I've never gotten to the point where I had a low battery, and I've been wearing it every single day with beta 1 and beta 2, so no issues there, at least for me. Now, should you install watchOS 7.4 beta 3? Well, if you're on the betas, I would say absolutely. However, at first, I was a little bit nervous about that because Face ID with a mask wasn't working initially. And I actually had to restart my iPhone in order to get that to work. So initially I tried restarting the Apple Watch, turning the feature off and on, resetting Bluetooth. None of that worked until I restarted my iPhone running iOS 14.5 beta 3. Then I was able to get that feature to work again. So there was some bug there. And also my friend Steve Mosier had the same problem, only it was a little bit of a different error. After restarting, it worked fine. So if you're having that issue, a restart should work fine. So I would definitely install it if you were worried about that, since I tweeted about it and you may have seen that, but it seems to be working fine ever since the restart. However, if you're on watchOS 7.3 and might maybe want to try some new features, I would hold off unless you know what you're getting into. And what I mean by that is with watchOS 7.3 or any watchOS version, if you have a problem, the only way to restore to a previous version is to send it into Apple. So unless you have an Apple Watch sitting around that you can use as a spare or maybe an old one to load it onto, I wouldn't really do that unless you are okay with sending it into Apple, should you have an issue. So far, I haven't had an issue, but if you were to have one, that could be a concern. So that's it for watchOS 7.4 beta 3. Now, other than that, I'd be looking forward to maybe beta 4 in the future. And again, that final release in the end of March or early April. Now, for those of you that have asked me a few different times what this watch face is, this is a fairly simple watch face. If I go into it here, you'll see it's Infograph modular that I set up. But in order to have this piece in the middle here, you have to have the app called Lumi. So we'll scroll up here. This is a paid app and it shows you the different times of day or basically the best time to take photos, for example. So if you have the app Lumi, it tells you evening golden hour, which when you would take photos, or sunset, and then morning as well. Evening blue hour, morning blue hour. So it tells you all of that information and it's set up in the middle of the watch. So that's all this watch face is. It's nothing new. It's just Infograph modular with that installed. Also, I'll link this watch band below if some people want to know what it is. It's the Nomad Titanium watch band, but it's linked in the description as well. If you'd like to get your hands on the wallpaper in this video, of course, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.